Hey guys, I'm Jimmy. This is Making It Work. I appreciate you watching my channel. I wanted to make a video today about the top five reasons why you should become a mechanic. There's a lot of negativity towards being a mechanic in some circles. Matter of fact, even inside the tent, people kind of fire across the tent at each other and degrade mechanics a little bit too much for my liking. People like Scotty Comer and stuff. There's tons of them. He's just the first one that pops into my head. There's a whole bunch of positive people on YouTube too, like Scanner Danner. Paul, he's great. He teaches you how to be a better mechanic and admits his own faults and lets everyone know that he's human. With those two people, there's gigantic contrast between the two of them. But some people may wonder, do I ever want to be a mechanic, and why would I want to be a mechanic? That's this video is going to be about the top five reasons why being a mechanic is a good idea. One of the first reasons being a good mechanic is a good idea is because of job stability. Everyone always needs their car fixed. Even in economic downturns, when there's a little bit of turmoil in the economy and things start to go a little haywire with real estate or whatever it may be, people need their cars fixed. People have to get to work. And ambulances, fire trucks, the semis, the truckers on the road and all that kind of stuff. The military, all the things you hear all these things about, police, they don't go anywhere if there aren't mechanics keeping all the vehicles maintained and on the road operating properly. There's always a need for mechanics. I don't think the need for mechanics is ever going to take a downward turn. So like even through the COVID-19 quarantines and all that stuff, we closed down for 2 weeks and repainted the shop floors and the walls and stuff and redid the shop inside. We normally wouldn't have that opportunity because we're so busy. But we took 2 weeks and redid the shop. We opened back up after that, and we basically never missed a beat. We've been busy the whole time. Even during all the lockdowns and quarantines and the masks and all the other mandates, we're an essential service. So we never skipped a beat. That's something to consider if you're thinking about being a mechanic and you're not sure if it's right for you. One of the other things that you can consider is student loan debt. Some people are going to college thinking that they're going to get some great job and become the CEO of Amazon or something eventually because they got a college degree. It's not really realistic because very few people take their college degree and take it to the moon. You know, most people get a college degree. I think about 70% of them end up working in a different field than they got their degree. But they might acquire $50,000, $80,000, $100,000 worth of debt or more in the process. To be a mechanic, you can go to UTI or some of those schools if you want to get a little bit of the book knowledge, but you really need to get in the field. And that's a great way to become a mechanic is you could volunteer to work in a shop for a month as a helper, you know, cleaning up around the shop, working around the mechanics and seeing what they're up to. And they'll give you some tips and tricks, and you'll see what the environment's really like for a mechanic on a daily basis without acquiring a whole bunch of debt. Even if you work for a month or two or 6 months for free, you're not going to have any debt at the end of that like you would if you went to a trade school. And you'll have a really good idea what happens in real life in the shop. So that's something to consider too, and that's obviously a great option for people. That's how I started, on the gas pumps. And then I became a mechanic after a little bit of time, after proving my worth and doing small jobs. Little by little, it let me work my way up. But I kept pushing too to make sure they knew I wanted to keep going up. You know, you can't get an entry-level job in the field of mechanic as a lube tech or whatever title you want to give it. But you can't get in that job and just stay in that job and not speak up and let them know you want to get trained, you want to move up. So that's a great way to become a mechanic, is to get in at the entry level position or get in as an intern, even as a volunteer if you have to, and try to figure out what's going on, if it's really something you want to do or not. And you're going to eliminate a whole bunch of debt. That's definitely a big consideration. The third thing is there's a whole bunch of advancement opportunities in the mechanical field. You can do anything. You can get in at the entry level being a lube tech doing tire repairs and changing bulbs and little things like that, air filters and cabin filters. And little by little, you can work your way up. There's tons of opportunities for advancement in the field of auto repair. You know, eventually you could become, after you've worked in it a while, and if you keep on to pushing, you didn't want to be a mechanic at some point, you decide you wanted to be a service manager. You can actually attain that. You can work in the field, in the shop, learn a lot about what's going on around you and how things are organized, And if you're good at that kind of thing, you can decide, well, hey, I don't have to get greasy and dirty and cut my hands anymore. I'll get into management. You can be a shop foreman, service manager, a team leader, any of those things. There's always opportunity in the field of auto repair to keep going up. Eventually, you can own your own shop. You know, once you've learned enough about repairing cars and how to do what we do on a daily basis, you can, and you set some money aside, if you're good with your money especially, and you don't spend it all every week. You know, tool debt's a big thing. I have a separate video on that. But if you're good with your money, you could eventually have your own shop and not have to answering to a boss. You always have to answer to a customer, and a customer is basically going to be your boss. Whether you have a boss at the shop you work at, or you own the shop, and you have the customer will be your boss, but you're always going to have that aspect of it, and you have to treat them like a family member if you want a long-term relationship and to build your business. But that's how a lot of people have done it. I had my own shop for a short period of time, but I unfortunately, I'm not real business savvy, or wasn't at the time. I've learned a lot since then, but I got involved with someone who is a shyster and got taken advantage of, and they used my hard work to gain for themselves. And I wasn't smart enough, I was pretty naive, and I trusted them. And I ended up getting taken advantage of, and I lost that business because of that. But I still could do it again if I wanted to. I feel like I'm getting a little older on in years, so I haven't really pushed that envelope. But I could. You know, if I wanted to open my own shop again, I could. I'm making pretty good money where I'm at right now. But anybody can get in at the entry level, work their way up a step at a time, get the training, certifications, all those things you need, and experience is the biggest thing. And you could take it, you know, sky's the limit in this industry for advancement. Another great thing about working in the field as an auto mechanic is the variety of things you do on a daily basis. You know, some people are good at repeating things. You know, you could assemble things in a factory, and you could just constantly put the square peg in the square hole and the round peg in the round hole all day long if you want to do that. There's nothing wrong with that. You could be an accountant, and you're crunching numbers all day, you're filling out, you know, the 1099 form, you know, over and over and over every day. And some people are great at that. There's not a good or bad thing about that. But in the automotive field, if you want variety in your job, you know, like today alone, I worked on a BMW, an F-250 commercial vehicle, a Hummer H2, a Hyundai Genesis, Mercedes-Benz, and a 71 Camaro all in one day. And all different kinds of problems with each vehicle. So the variety is endless. If you want a job that's exciting from the standpoint that, you know, that day you might be doing something totally new and figuring out something new and how it works. And, you know, like I always say, when a car comes in on a tow truck, you work on it, get it fixed, and you see that thing drive away, that's really satisfying. So that's one of the great things about this profession, is the variety of things you can do on a daily basis. Definitely in my top five. Number five would be the independence you get from being a mechanic, especially if you're on a flat rate. If you work in a shop that's salary or hourly, it's a little bit different. But when you work in the flat rate system as a mechanic, you're basically your own boss, even if you have to answer to somebody and they're pushing you about numbers and all those kinds of things. In reality, you're your own boss. No matter what they say or how hard they push you or what they expect from you, you have your bay or two bays, depending on what kind of shop you work in. Sometimes they'll give you three bays, depending on how big the shop is and how many guys. But you could have multiple bays at your discretion and work as hard as you want. If you're tired, you can take it easy that day. If you're getting paid flat rate, you'll get a percentage of the labor. If the shop charges $100 an hour, you might make $20, $25, $30 an hour, sometimes more. If the shop charges $150, you might make $30, $40, or $50 an hour or more. But you're in charge of whether you're going to do 30 hours a week, 40 hours a week, 60 hours a week. I mean, I've worked with guys that do 150 hours a week. I don't really recommend going to that level. Work is 55, 60 hours a week and turn 150 clock hours. That might be a little bit sketchy, but it's possible. Depends on how motivated and aggressive you want to be. If you're not going to be aggressive and you're going to stand in place and you're not going forward, you're not going to advance. So there's all kinds of opportunities in that regard as far as making money and running things like it's your own business. You got a lot of independence. You're basically your own master. You're determining what you produce each week, and that you get paid based on your effort. Some people don't like that because they don't want to put a lot of effort in. But most people like it because they want to, especially people that aren't afraid of hard work. You want to get some cars done. You want to get them done right so you don't have to work on them again. And you're your own master. You got a lot of independence in that regard when you're a mechanic. You know, if you want to take 5 minutes to head into the pooper and get on your phone and talk to your girlfriend on your phone for a second in the pooper, you got to hide it from your boss usually, but you don't really have to, but you're your own boss. A lot of independence as a mechanic in this industry. The last thing is kind of a bonus. I said top five, but this is the sixth thing. The job satisfaction as a mechanic is enormous. And, you know, people tend to not really account much for that. You know, you see people like Scotty Kilmer telling you how many mechanics are thieves and mechanics will rip you off and this brand's terrible and this brand's horrible and people are stupid, one video after another. The guy is so negative, I don't know how he has 5 million subscribers. The satisfaction that comes with doing a good job, when a car comes in on a flatbed, it doesn't run or doesn't start or whatever the case may be, and you put your time and effort into it and you get that car fixed, and that car drives away. You know, I've stayed late to help somebody get their van running again when they had a fuel pump out. There's a whole bunch of stories I could tell you about that kind of thing. But what it all boils down to is job satisfaction. There's not a lot of jobs, other than maybe in the medical industry, where you're taking care of problems and you're seeing the results of your effort. I mean, it's hardcore, right there in your face. This thing came in broken. You figured it out with the tools that you bought and the knowledge and experience you have and training or whatever you've got. And you got that thing on the road again. Whether you're going to make a video on YouTube about how no one else could have fixed this but me or not, that's up to you. But in reality, that satisfaction is immense. I mean, I don't know what that's worth basically, but I could have a job where I made a lot more money and didn't get that kind of satisfaction, and it would be shallow and empty for me, and I probably wouldn't stay long because... you know, that it's very gratifying to realize on a daily basis how many people you can help being a mechanic and being a good mechanic. And that's what I think everyone in the industry should be striving for. To be more like Scanner Danner. You know, Paul's a great guy. To emulate him and to try to do what's right by customers and to be thorough at your job. Working in flat rate's kind of tough. When you're making YouTube videos, you have a little bit of leeway because you're basically working on vehicles that someone's probably tried to figure out already and thrown some parts at, so you know it's not going to need those parts. You put a little more time and effort into it, and you're going to film it while you're doing it when you're making a YouTube channel. But when you're working on flat rate, it's a little bit different. So you kind of take all your possibilities and you're narrowing them down to the slightest of possibilities, and where there's a couple potential problems, a couple potential possibilities, and then sometimes you install a part because the part and the labor to put that part in is going to be way less than the troubleshooting and the oscilloscopes and the transducers and all those other things that you might need to pinpoint that problem ahead of time. So the flat rate industry is not really perfect in that regard, but if you care about what you're doing and you've gained experience, you can eliminate a lot of those other things and get right to the root cause of the battery went dead. But I was talking about Scanner Danner. You know, if you can be more like a Scanner Danner kind of guy, and you got to combine that with the flat rate reality world, I mean, the YouTube stuff and a lot of the YouTube repair channels are great. A lot of those guys are really good mechanics. Paul's really good about not degrading mechanics in that regard, which I really like. That's one of the reasons I subscribed to his channel. But what was that? Next, he tries to help the industry and make mechanics better. So that's something you need to emulate, even as a flat rate mechanic, where you don't really have the kind of time it takes to dive into problems in the detail he does, and he shows you what's going on so you know. But once you take that knowledge that you get from him and apply your experience and that knowledge, you can usually arrive at the problem a lot faster and not have to do all the oscilloscope and the another testing. Not that I'm saying that's a bad thing. I'm just saying in the flat rate world, like the dealership world, it's really similar. You have test parts and you'll actually put a part on the car and see if it fixes it. If it doesn't, then you know you got a module or a wiring or connector problem. And you check all those things anyway, because most of them are pretty easy to pull a connector off and look inside. The bottom line is all of that rambling amounts to the fact that there's a lot of job satisfaction. And you determine the level you go to on each repair. you verifying that you fixed it correctly before you're ever delivering it back to the car, back to the customer. So even if you have done something where you took a guess at something, you got to a certain point, you took a guess, it may not have been 100% right, something didn't quite go well, but you're not delivering the car back yet. You're not done. The only problem I have with mechanics when they're not done and they give the car back anyway. But if you take a guess or you're troubleshooting something, you get to a point where you're pretty certain that that's going to fix it. There's nothing wrong with putting that part in there and seeing if it's going to fix it at that point. In the flat rate world, there's not a lot of reward for spending hours and hours and hours checking something only to find out it had a bad ignition coil. So the bottom line is the job satisfaction is immense, and I think that's pretty invaluable. That makes the pay you get combined with the job satisfaction just phenomenal. You're fixing cars and keep people on the road, you're able to get to work. We have a customer that needed her car fixed so she can go to this place where her husband's buried. So we do pretty important work too, and it's very satisfying. So those are my top five reasons, and one bonus, why it's good being a mechanic, and it's not a taboo thing like people might make you believe. There's way too much of that on YouTube. So I want you guys to keep your heads up, improve yourselves, and keep trying to learn, and taking all the training you can get. Be smart with your money when it comes to tools and purchases. In this business, there's a whole lot of money you can spend. You can make it so that you're bankrupt trying to buy tools to keep up. So you got to be really smart with all those decisions too, but that's for a separate video. Hope some of these opinions helped you out. I've been doing this for 40 years. I'm Master Certified and Advanced Engine Performance Certified, or L1, along with a bunch of, I have some truck and some natural gas certifications and things like that too. But my experience is it's a great job. And I think you guys who are considering this job, this occupation, you know, don't let people tell you, oh, mechanic, you're going to get your hands dirty. You know, so a good mechanic nowadays makes $70,000 to $150,000 a year. So consider that too. You make more than most people with college degrees. And I think we'll end this video right there. Thanks for watching. Appreciate you tuning in and making it work. And we'll see you in the next video.